U.S. Navy will have four Orca extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles, XLUUVs. Pentagon has announced that Boeing has been awarded a $43 million contract to build these. The Orca will eventually become a multi-mission platform for the service. Boeing stated in a brief, "We are pleased with the Navy's decision to award Boeing a contract to build and deliver four Orca extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles and are committed to providing this important autonomous undersea capability to meet the Navy's unique mission needs." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes Orca extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles. Let's get started. The Pentagon stated, "The Orca XLUUV will be modular in construction, with the core vehicle providing guidance and control, navigation, autonomy, situational awareness, core communications, power distribution, energy and power, propulsion and maneuvering, and mission sensors. It will have well-defined interfaces for the potential of implementing cost-effective upgrades in future increments to leverage advances in technology and respond to threat changes. The service plans to use the Orcas and explore and refine future concepts of operation for underwater drones of this size, which could include gathering intelligence, emplacing or clearing naval mines, attacking other ships or submarines, conducting standoff strikes, and more." There was two main competing parties, Lockheed Martin and Boeing. In October 2017, both companies received design phase awards. Lockheed's proposed design was a vessel that was shaped like an enlarged torpedo. Boeing's design is similar to a small submarine and is, to a large extent, derived from a previous private venture known as Echo Voyager, which is an unmanned diesel-electric submersible. Ultimately, the Navy preferred Boeing's design and hence it was given the contract. Boeing Orca is a 51-foot long submersible, is launched from a pier and can operate autonomously. It's designed to be able to sail up to 6,500 nautical miles without being connected to a manned mothership. Initially, the Orca is expected to perform mine and countermine warfare. The Orca XLUUV will be open architecture and hence reconfigurable depending on specific mission requirements. So later ones, the mission will be expanded to include anti-submarine warfare, anti-surface warfare, electronic warfare, and strike missions. Though Orcas will be able to perform a slew of missions in the future, the initial mission of mine laying and mine clearing is a very important one. Naval mine detection and sweeping is a slow and difficult job, especially in war situations where there's enemy fire. Deploying large minesweepers is costly and also risky. Orca will be much harder to detect, being much smaller, and are easily replaceable, as they are much cheaper and have no personnel. It's also to be noted that Orcas will be ideal for laying mines, as they can cover large areas autonomously and discreetly. It's a much safer and efficient way of performing this task. Importantly, being smaller, they could even get close to the enemy's coastline and deploy mines in strategic points. Ability to move autonomously is not an easy feat. This requires a highly advanced level of AI. America has already demonstrated this capability with the Sea Hunter project. U.S. Navy's Sea Hunter project achieved something amazing recently. Medium Displacement Unmanned Surface Vehicle, MDUSV, Sea Hunter became the first craft to ever sail from San Diego, California to Pearl Harbor, Hawaii and back without needing any onboard crew. To know more, viewers can check the video on above card. Though certain quarters have raised questions about America's progress in AI, these demonstrations clearly indicate that it's on the right path. It must also be noted here that orcas will be networked, where they'll work as a team, and because of this, they could be more effective in carrying out the missions assigned to them when compared to a standalone naval vessel. The orcas will provide the U.S. Navy with valuable experience in operating this kind of craft and would help it in finalizing plans for future large-diameter unmanned undersea vehicles (LDUUV) that are meant to be launched from submarines such as the Virginia class. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.